Hallelujah. 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 Saints of God, I'm full today. I'm truly full. And I want to be brief if I can. Let me turn this music down. But I'm actually full today. So much I want to say. Some things I may not need to say, but so much I want to say. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless you all. Bless you all for coming in. Apostle Stan, bless you, my brother. Bless you. Pastor O. Hallelujah. I love you guys. Thank you for coming on in here with me. Hallelujah. Shalom, shalom. Apostle Stanley J. Love you, man. Love you. Thank you all for coming in and fellowshipping with me. I really love you guys. I thank you for supporting the ministry. Pastor O, I love you, dear. I love you. I really do appreciate you for your support. Robert, thank you, Robert. My cousin Gerald, bless you, Pastor Nance. My cousin there. Love you, man. Diane King, how you doing, dear? Good to see you. Your face. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you. Thank you all for coming in and supporting the ministry that the Lord has given us. And I just want to say a couple things. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you, Apostle Stan. A couple things I want to say to get out of the way. All right? Because I got some stuff on my heart. Hallelujah. I should have been timing myself because let me see what time it is. All right. Because I don't want to keep you guys too long. But I got some stuff in my heart. Thank you. That I want to deal with. First of all, let me just start out by saying this. That I've gotten rebuked for Renee. How you doing, Renee? All right, let me stop giving shout outs. I love you, Renee. Thank you. I've gotten rebuked for not asking or giving the people the opportunity to sow into what God has given me. I've gotten rebuked for that by several people. I've got inbox messages with people saying, how can we sow? How can we give? And I just want to say now, I'm probably going to get in trouble for this, what I'm about to say right now, but that's okay. That's okay. I'm going to do it anyway. I just want to say that the reason why I'm very reluctant about that, because you guys know there are many shysters within the kingdom. There are many shysters within the kingdom. Hey, Auntie Mary, I love you. Many shysters within the kingdom. My son, third day, the mouthpiece, my namesake. I love you, son. All right, let me stop with the shout-outs. I give a lot of shout-outs because I love you guys, and I love you for coming on. But I want to say that I don't ask because there's so many shysters within the kingdom, and there are so many people who have taken that which is good and turned it into evil. Now, God turns evil into good. Shysters turn good into evil. Y'all feel that? Shysters will turn good into evil. Now, the Spirit of God will take that which seems bad and it'll turn it into something great. So I try to stay away from the money situation because there's so many shysters and crooks that have done it wrong. But I've been rebuked and they told me just because there's one bad cop don't make all cops bad. Just because you got some bad pastors don't make all pastors bad. So just because somebody has messed up the art of giving and receiving, that don't mean that giving and receiving is wrong. All right, I receive that. So if you want to sow into Apostle Webster's ministry and what God has given me, I put the cash tag on the title. You see it. I put the PayPal on there. And if you want to just sow into the ministry, I put the church website on there also. Okay? So I love you guys, and I appreciate if you sow. It ain't like I don't need it. Yes, I need it. But you got to be so wise in how you do things nowadays. All right? No, okay, now, next. Carolyn Cobb, how you doing, young lady? Long time, no see. I love you, Carolyn. Now, Prophet Misha, I humbly bow, Prophet. Shalom. All right, I said I was going to stop doing shout-outs until the end, but I can't resist. I love to see you guys coming on. Now, the next thing I want to say is this, before I get into what I want to talk about today. The next thing I want to say is this. You know, it just kind of, it's really weird for me to see the trend that's happening within the body of Christ today. That there's a trend where we can do anything we want to do without having any biblical backing at all and still have the support of the church and the support of the body of Christ at large. Saints of God, I got news for you guys. And I might lose some friends for this, I might lose some friends for this, but those of you who really love me, you'll love me. I got news for you. I got news for you. Shalom, prophet. I got news for you. When we make decisions and we do things without biblical backing, listen, people of God, we are leaders. I'm a leader in the body of Christ. I'm a leader. You hear that? I'm a leader in the body of Christ. I can't just make decisions without biblical backing. I'm doing this because I feel like doing it. But where's your scripture at, Apostle? I don't have no scriptures. It's just what I feel like doing. I'm just tired, so I'm going to do this without biblical backing and still have the support of the body of Christ. Shalom, Rochelle. Bless you, dear. What type of stuff is this? So what we can just make our own as leaders and still have the body of Christ embrace us and say, oh, it's okay. Well, I got news for y'all, people of God. This brother here, I'm going to be by myself. I'm going to stand alone if I have to. I'm going to be by myself, and I bet you I stand inside of the word of God, covered by the grace of God and covered by God's word. Hear me. The scriptures and the word of God is going to be my protection, my fortress. I'm not going to just decide to do stuff just because I feel like doing it and I'm just tired and I don't want to do this and I don't have no scripture to back me up. What scripture am I using? Come on, thank you. Thank you, Apostle Stan. Thank you, Pastor O. Come on now. We got to have the Bible backing us. So I'm going to tell y'all right now, I'm saying this on Facebook Live. When Apostle Webster get out of order and I decide I'm going to be out of order with no scripture, y'all better rebuke me. Y'all better say, Apostle, you know you're wrong. Come on, love me enough. The Bible said, open rebuke is better than secret love. Love me enough to openly say, Apostle, that's not right. Now, you can keep on loving me, but you ain't got to agree with my mess. So I'm just saying it because, you know, those of you who know me, you know why I'm saying it. It just baffles my mind that we can do these things. No biblical backing at all. No scripture to back us at all. But then we do these things, and then the body of Christ yet embrace us and say, oh, it's going to be okay. Oh, it's all right. No, it's not all right. It's not all right for me as a leader to do what I feel like doing just because I feel like doing it. Not okay. All right, done with that. I love you guys. Done with that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, I want to talk to you today about the flow of God. All right, Apostle Stan, I feel you, man. About the flow of God. Listen, the scripture talks plainly about the flow. St. John chapter 7, Yeshua says, out of your belly shall flow rivers, plural, of living water. This is what Yeshua says. Out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. All right? All right, Brother Rodney, shalom, my brother. And you tell Teacher Williams, I said shalom. All right? You tell Teacher, I said shalom. Out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Now hear this. When Yeshua speaks, he said in St. John 6:63 that the words that I speak, they are spirit and they are life. So whenever the Messiah is talking, people, he didn't talk because he was bored. He didn't talk because he had nothing to do or nothing to say. Hallelujah. When the Messiah spoke, he spoke out of his heart and he spoke out of the mind of God. He spoke from the Kail, the life of God. He spoke out of the wisdom of God. All right, the Sophia. So when Yeshua is talking, don't take anything he says for granted. I hope y'all with me. Don't take what he said for granted. Yeshua speaks from life. And he said, out of your belly shall flow rivers, plural, of living water. What is he talking about? What is he talking about? Rivers. I know we said, well, he's talking about the Spirit of God. He's talking about us speaking in tongues. True, true, true. He's talking about the flow of God in our life. True, true. Now, hear this. In Matthew chapter 13, Yeshua speaks and he talks about the sower that went forth to sow. People of God, please unplug your ear. Unplug your ear. Pull the cotton out of your ear. Take the ear stoppers out and hear this. Let the Spirit hear. Let they that have an ear, let them hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. All right? Take your ear stoppers out and hear this. When the scripture says, a sower went forth to sow. A sower went forth to sow. And it said, some seed fell by the wayside. Some seed fell among thorns. Some seed fell in stony places. And some seed fell on good ground and brought forth fruit. right? Now, the seed is what I want to focus on. The seed has a multiplicity of understanding. Now, I don't even know if multiplicity is a word, but I'm an apostle, so I can make words up. Hallelujah. All right, Apostle Jay, I'm an apostle. I can make words up. So the seed, which is the word of God, has a multiplicity of understanding. So then the tree, if you have a tree, look outside, you see a tree. The tree, the seed is inside of the tree. Y'all feel that? How many of you have sat down to a meal and you've eaten three whole chickens in one setting? Hear what I'm telling you. You've done it. Everybody on this feed, most of us have done it. You sit down and you have three whole chickens in one meal. Most of us have done it. All right. Thank you all for coming on. I appreciate it. Love you guys. Archbishop, I love you. Ted, I love you. Hallelujah. Alexis, hey, cuz. So hear me now. Hear me real good. So now, you sat down to a meal and you've eaten three whole chickens. How have you did that? Because if you eat three whole eggs, then you've eaten three whole chickens because the chicken is inside the egg. Y'all feel that? So the word, the seed of God is multiplicit. So when you consume the seed of God, you consume the entire word, the entire kingdom. The scripture said you can't point and say, "Lord, look, here's the kingdom or there's the kingdom." The scripture said the kingdom is where? Within you. So when you consume the word of God, you consume the kingdom of God. And wherever there's an effect, there's an effect. And wherever there's an effect, there's an infect. Hear what I'm telling you. So a lot of us, we have people that, shalom, Malach's messenger. Say, "Hi, Mr. Webster. How you doing, Mr. Messenger? Love you." Now check this out. Whenever you have an effect, you have an effect and you have an infect. Some people have been affected. Now, you can be affected, that's cool. But when that thing that has affected you begin to cause an effect, if you don't stop it, if you don't get rid of it, it's going to cause you to be infected. Y'all feel that? Effect is 30-fold, effect is 60-fold, infect is 100-fold. When you've been affected by something, the scripture said evil communications corrupt good manners. Evil communications corrupt good manners. So when you have been affected by something, if you don't get deliverance from that thing that has affected you, it will begin to affect you. And when it affects you, then if you don't stop it, it's going to infect you and you're going to become an infectious person. Oh, hallelujah. You will be an infectious person going around spreading disease. Yeah, you might be saved. Yeah, you might be Holy Ghost filled. Yeah, you speak with tongues, but you are infectious. Why? Because you refuse to get delivered. Now you're running around with a very subtle, infectious spirit, infecting people, and you don't even know it. You've been told, but you won't receive it. Come on now. When you consume the word of God, that's right, Pastor O, you consume the kingdom of God. Now hear this. This is what the flow will do. The flow will purify you. Affect, effect, and infect. That's right. The flow will purify you. People are infected because they're not flowing. But when you begin to flow, that flow that Yeshua spoke about, that flow will begin to purify you. Thank you, Third Day. Third Day said, then you have a defect. Hallelujah. Thank you, son. So now, when you begin to flow like Yeshua said, there's a script in the book of Isaiah. It says that Yeshua, speaking of Yeshua, said that he was a tender plant and dry ground. Hear me, people of God. Yeshua was a tender plant in dry ground. The word tender plant in the Hebrew is yarnak. It's yarnak. It has to do with how people say, except you have faith as a grain of a mustard seed. Yarnak is the Hebrew term for that. It's a Hebrew term for that. Hallelujah. Thank you, Apostle Woods. I love you, man. Appreciate that. Yarnak is a Hebrew term. Now, what it means is, it means that you remain anointed. It means you remain anointed regardless of what's happening around you. You're not a tender plant. Where? In dry ground. That means everything around you is dry. Everything around you is dead. But you're not. You are anointed not because of the things that are around you, but because of the thing that is in you. The flow that is in you. When you have the word of God, you digest that word, no effect, no effect, no infect will bother you, because even if you have been infected, when you allow the word of God to flow through you, hey, baby sister, I love you. When you allow that, that the word of God to flow through you, it washes you of all the effect. It cleanses you of all the effect. It purges you of all the infection that is in you from other people, from other situations, past lives, past relationships. I'm going to tell you, people of God, there are a lot of infected people, a lot of infected people in the body of Christ, and they're infecting others. Let me tell you this. I heard somebody say this. I didn't know what it meant when they said it, but they said hurting people hurt people. Now, I didn't know, it makes sense, but I didn't feel it like I feel it today. So when you've been wounded and you've been hurt and you don't get healed, you end up hurting other people. And you will deny it. There are so many people in denial. Oh, it ain't me. So many people in denial. You're infecting other people. You need the flow. You need the flow. Yeshua said, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Now, when he said rivers, he wasn't talking about just a river. He was talking to, oh, Pastor Cooper, bless you, man. Love you. He wasn't talking about a river, rivers, a river for the body, a river for the soul, and a river for the spirit. Rivers of living water will flow out of you. Now, also, David, when David went to fight Goliath, we call him Goliath, his name was Goliath. When David went and fought Goliath, he stopped by the brook on the way to fight Goliath. Hear me, people of God. He stopped by the brook, and he picked up five smooth stones. He picked up five smooth stones. Why did he pick up five smooth stones? There was a purpose behind that. Five smooth stones. How did the stones become smooth? They become smooth because they've been in the water. You're not tender, anointed, wet. They've been in the water for a long time. People of God, when you allow the flow to come up and out of you, when you allow the flow to cleanse you, you become smooth. You become, come on now, you tell the devil you've been hit by a smooth criminal. I couldn't resist that one. So you become smooth, and when rocks that are smooth are able to be thrown straight, they can be thrown straight. Hallelujah. Thank you. They can be thrown very straight when they're smooth. Rocks with jagged edges, they fight against the wind and they fight against the flow. But David picked up five smooth stones. Those stones were smooth because they've been in the flow for a long time. They've been in that water and the water was rushing over them, and they've been in that water for a long time, because the water will purge you. The flow will cleanse you. The flow will make you clean and purge you, people of God. But people don't want to be in the flow. They don't want to be in the flow. They want to do whatever they want to do. And then they'll tell you this. They say, well, I cooperated with you. Well, listen, we don't need cooperation. We need flow operation. Feel me, people of God. We need flow operation. The kingdom of God is not a cooperation. It's a flow operation. We have to flow within the kingdom. Understand this. God will grow you in one place and then flow you in another place. Feel that. He'll grow you in one place, but then he'll flow you in another place. That's what God will do. That's what God will do. He'll grow you up, and then he'll flow you up. The flow is what we need. The flow is what we need to flow in the kingdom of God. How flow can you go? Notice this. There's many scriptures in the Bible. I've counted about at least 15 or 16 scriptures in the Bible. Talks about many waters. Notice that. The scripture talks about many waters. Then notice the scripture that says, What's the word? Genesis chapter 1 verse 11. It talks about the tree bringing forth fruit after its kind. Hear that, people of God. Hear me. After its kind. Yeshua said, this kind goeth not out but by prayer and fasting. Remember, I said the word of God is multiplicit. The word of God is multiplicit. It's a seed. Inside of that seed lives the kingdom. He said, this kind goeth not out but by prayer and fasting. Well, let me explain this kind to you. You can look at it how you want to look at it. But the word kind there, the word kind, we can say, well, he's talking about this kind of demon. Y'all know the backstory. There was a young man, and actually the young man had epilepsy. The young man had epilepsy, but it was not diagnosed at that time. They didn't know the man had epilepsy. They just said when the moon comes out and there's a full moon, that his body goes into convulsion and he does this. Well, it's because whether we know it or not, or whether we like it or not, people of God, oh man, I'm trying not to say too much here. I don't want to scare nobody, all right? But the moon has to do with the frequency of the sea level. Hear me. And our bodies are made up of 75% liquid. Our body responds to the moving of the sea level because our physical body is liquid on the inside. Feel that, people of God? So that young man had epilepsy, and when the moon was full, the tide would pour, and it would disrupt. It would disrupt who he is, all right? It would disrupt who he is. So now, understand that he would go into these seizures, and they didn't know that it was epilepsy. It was misdiagnosed. They said he was a lunatic, L-U-N-A-T-I-C, or L-U-N-A-R, lunar tick, moved by the moon. But Yeshua comes along. He told his disciples to go forth, heal the sick, raise the dead, you know, do these things. Now, notice this, that the apostles couldn't heal the guy. The apostles couldn't heal the guy. They prayed and they prayed. They couldn't heal the guy. However, when Yeshua came along, he laid hands on the young boy and he healed him. The apostles pulled him aside to a private meeting. And they said, look here, Lord, look here. Why are you fronting? They said, come here, Doc. Why you put us on blast like that? You told us to go out and heal the sick, raise the dead, and then we try to heal this boy. We can't do it. And then here you come, and you're going to cast the devil out. Just put us on blast. I can imagine that's how the conversation went. But Yeshua said to them this. He said, how long will I have to be with you, O faithless and perverse or backwards generation? How long will I have to be with you? How long will I suffer you? And he said this. He said, you could not cast him out because of your unbelief. Because of what? Your unbelief. He said, but this kind goeth not forth but by prayer and fasting. When he said this kind, people of God, the word kind there is genios, or generation. He's talking about a kind of people that's like him. A kind of people that's going to flow like him. A flow generation. Not a cooperation, but a flow operation. A generation of flowers. Those who don't mind flowing in the spirit. When you flow in the spirit, people don't know whether you're going or coming. Because when you flow in the spirit, you go wherever the spirit takes you. You're in the waters of the spirit. The scripture talks about the many waters in the book of Revelation. John said, I heard a voice sound like many waters. In the book of 2 Samuel, he said the Lord was in the many waters. In the book of Ezekiel, he said the Lord was in the many waters. When you get to flowing, you begin to flow and you just lay out and just let the Lord move you as he will, and you begin to flow in the spirit, I'm going to tell you what, you will be purged. There ain't no better purging than an old-fashioned Holy Ghost purging, being purged and cleansed by the spirit. That's the best way to be cleansed. So now, the scripture says that he said, this kind goeth not out, but by prayer and fasting. What do you mean, this kind? This kind, generation of people, the people that will flow. Notice what Psalms 1 say. Notice what Psalms 1 say, people. Hear this. Psalms 1 talks about, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. Right? Psalms 1, right? It says, but his delight is in the law of the Lord. God bless you, Kelly. How you doing, Arthur? His delight is in the law of the Lord. Shalom, people. All you just coming on, I love you guys. I said I was going to stop doing shout-outs, but I love you. Angelia, I love you. Thank you for coming on. Robert Eggers, how you doing, my brother? Man, long time. Leonard Dwayne Carter, love you, brother. I love you. Appreciate you. All right. Now, this kind goeth not out, but by prayer and fasting. This kind, generation, genios. Now, Psalms 1, hear the word. Hear the word. Let me do it again. Psalms 1, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. Hear the word. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in this law doeth he meditate when? Day and night, good times and bad, trial and joy. In this law doeth he meditate when? Day and night. Now here it comes. And he shall be like a tree. What kind of tree is he going to be like? A tree planted by the rivers. There that river is again. By the rivers of water. And he shall bring forth his fruit in his season. People of God, the tree planted by the rivers of waters is not a tree planted next to the water. Planted by the rivers of water. planted by the rivers. Look, the tree was planted by the Lord. So that means that the Lord himself is the one doing the planting. Shalom, Evangelist Palmer. Shalom, Prophet LV. Listen now. So now, the Lord is doing the planting. A tree planted by the rivers of water. That means the rivers or the flow is the thing planting you. I'm not next to the water, people of God. The water has planted me. He should be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. Y'all feel that? So the waters has planted me. So then my depth is determined by my flow. My flow is determined by my depth. So the water has planted me. Not next to the water, but I'm planted by the water. The flow is the thing that's planting me. Are y'all with me? So then when you begin to flow, you will begin to grow. You will get purged. You will not affect anyone. You will not affect anyone. And you definitely sure won't infect anyone. And you won't have a defect at all. When you begin to flow right and let the word of God purge you, let the word of God cleanse you, let the word of God purge you out. Hallelujah. Then you understand what the flow is. Then you understand how to flow. A lot of people don't even know how to flow. Let it go, people. Flow. David got 5 smooth stones. 5 representing the ministry. 5 representing the 5 senses. 5 representing the 5 cranial bones in your skull. 5 smooth stones purged by the water. Purified by the flow. This is what we have to be. We have to let the word of God come over us and wash us. Wash us with the washing of the water of your word. Wash us and cleanse us. Hallelujah. Wash us and cleanse us with the washing of the water by the word. I love my sisters. I love you, Mercedes. Hallelujah. Are y'all feeling me right now? Washed by the washing of the word. Purged and cleansed by God's word. You see, people of God, we don't want to be infectious. We don't want to affect people. We don't look. You may think you're delivered. You may think you're all good, but I got news for you. If you're doing things without biblical backing, you are not delivered. I'm sorry, people. Yeah, I said it. I know I might get in trouble for saying it, but if your decision making is not backed up or not founded on the word of God, you need some deliverance. That goes for me and everybody else. As soon as we as leaders start making decisions outside of God's word, something's wrong, people. And then the kingdom of God rushes and says, oh, you okay? You all right? But look, people of God, we have got to understand. We got to understand that it's time now for people who really love God and really love his word to conduct ourselves according to God's word. According to God's word, nothing else. I will not be moved by anybody's opinion. I'm not going to be moved by what you feel or what you think. Hallelujah. We got to be moved only by the word. Only by the word. Revelation chapter 1. What time is it? I don't want to be before you too long. Revelation chapter 1, last verse. In Revelation 1, John said he heard a voice that sounded like many waters. He said, I heard the voice of many waters. Then the scripture says he turned not to hear the voice, but he turned to do what? To perceive the voice. He turned to see the voice. Hallelujah. And the scripture said it was the voice of many waters. The flow. He heard the flow, people. People of God, you can hear it. When you begin to get into the spirit, you can hear the flow. You can hear the flow. You can feel the flow of God washing over you. I had a dream once in 1990. I was running in Minneapolis, Minnesota. I lived in Minneapolis, Minnesota in 1990. And I was running from the grocery store. And behind me, there was a wave. And this wave was chasing me. And I was running from this wave. I mean, I was high-telling the people. I was getting down. I was tracking out like Prophet Mission. I was on the track and I was hitting it. And that flow was behind me. This great big wave was coming over me. And it was covering me. And I was trying my best to get out the way. I was trying my best to move. And pretty soon I got tired. I couldn't run no more. And I gave up. I took a deep breath because I knew that water was finna hit me. I said, I took that deep breath and the water just overflowed me. And it covered me. And when the water covered me, people, I couldn't hold my breath no longer. And I knew I was getting ready to die. So I inhaled. And when I inhaled, I could breathe underwater. And God began to speak to me and said, the flow won't kill you. The flow will heal you. Hallelujah. God says, I come that you have life. The flow won't kill you. The flow will heal you. Let the Lord surround you with the waters of his love. Let the Lord baptize you in the waters of his love. Let the flow overtake you. And you won't be dead. You'll be led. Hallelujah. You won't be dead, you'll be led. The flow won't kill you, it'll heal you. Oh, come on, Apostle Webster, you clowning right now. The flow won't kill you, it'll heal you. You won't be dead, you'll be led. Hallelujah. This is what the flow wants to do. I ran from that flow, and when it overtook me, I was breathing underwater because God says, I want you to flow in my spirit. I want you to flow in my spirit. People of God, I prophesy to you right now that you would begin to flow in his spirit. Allow the word of God. Allow the flow of God to overtake you. Allow the mood, the M-O-O-D of God to be in you and to lead you. Be led by the spirit of God. Be led by his spirit. You need a seeing eye dog. Yes, like a blind person need a seeing eye dog. My seeing eye dog is the Paracletos, the Ruach HaKodesh. The Holy Ghost will be my seeing eye dog, and I'll be led by the Spirit. Why? Because the flow has overtaken me. The flow has overtaken me. And when that flow is in you, when that flow is in you, okay, nothing stop you. How flow can you go? Somebody type that. How flow can you go? Hallelujah. Somebody type that. How flow can you go? Because when that flow is in you, the flow will heal you. It won't kill you. Hallelujah. You won't be dead. You'll be led. Hallelujah. How flow can you go? The word of God, people, the word of God is alive. Yeshua said, the words that I speak, they are spirit and they are life. And we have to understand this. We got to understand that the word comes to give us life. The word comes to give us life. How flow can you go, people? The word comes to give us life. Yes, type that. How flow can you go? I love you. I love you. I love God's word. I love God's word. You can use the prophet. Hallelujah. You can use that. It's yours, my brother. I love you all. I thank you all for listening. How flow can you go? Hallelujah. How flow can you go? People of God, look, the word of God is real. And we need to conform ourselves to the flow of God. We need to conform ourselves to his flow. It's time out for listening to everybody else. Time out for listening to people's opinion. Come on, your opinion is going to get flushed down the toilet. If what you're saying is not backed by scripture, people of God, this thing, whoo, hallelujah. This thing has got me on fire. It's got me on fire. How flow can you go? This thing has got me on fire. All this compromise within the body of Christ. People of God, I never saw so much compromise in my life. And I'm seeing it up front. I'm seeing it up front in my face, compromise. Just decide to do stuff. And then the body of Christ rush and comfort you. People of God, time out for that. This apostle right here, I'll be by myself. I'll be by myself. If I got to be alone to stand in the word of God, I'll be by myself. Hallelujah. Feel that. Feel that. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Because I refuse to act outside of God's word. I'm not going to do it. And if I get out of God's word, I give you all permission to rebuke me. Come on. Come on. You don't get outside of God's word and then people come along and baby you up. No. Everything we do, Apostle Donald Givens, everything we do has to be founded inside of the word of God. Flow, people. Don't run from the flow. Run to the flow. Don't run from it. Run to it. Hallelujah. Allow the flow to overtake you and overwhelm you. The waters of his love. The Bible talked about husband and wife. The scripture says he shall wash her with the washing of the waters of the word. Hallelujah. Your words, people, your words should be washing. Your words should be health. When you speak to people, you should speak life into them. Speak life into them. Your words should be healing ointment. Your words shouldn't be negative. Your words shouldn't be painful. Your words shouldn't be seasoned with crap. Did I say crap? I said it. Your words shouldn't be seasoned with crap. It should be seasoned with salt. Your words should be life-giving. Yeshua said, the words that I speak, they are spirit and they are life. Hallelujah. I love you all. I love you all. How flow can you go? How flow can you go? Allow the word of God. Allow the word of God to flow through you. Allow that word to flow through you. I'm done, people of God. I love you. For those just coming on, Apostle Brenda, Shalom, Miss Pekah. For those of you just coming on, Pastor Rochelle, start the video from the beginning and watch it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Pastor O, hallelujah. I feel you. I love that flow, people of God. I can feel it. Y'all feel that? I can feel that flow. I can feel the flow of the Holy Ghost. Let me give you this quick testimony before I close out. The other day I was praying, and I had my hands up like this. And I was praying with my hands lifted. And I had my hands up for so long, and I was praying for so long. After when I ended my prayer, I forgot that my hands were lifted. I've been praying for so long, I forgot my hands were lifted. And so when I was coming out of the prayer, I noticed I saw these two arms next to me that were up. And I said to myself, whose arms are those? And I remember thinking, are those my arms? And I thought, try to move one and see what happens. So I said, I tried to move one and it started coming down. I said, oh, those are my arms. So I pulled them down. My point is, when you get caught up in the flow, when you get caught up in the prayer, the things that usually affect your physical body will be of none effect. If I would have been in the flesh with my hands up for over an hour and a half, my body would have got tired, my shoulders would have gotten weakened, and my hands would have failed. But they didn't fall because I was flowing. I was in the flow. That's why. Because when you're in that flow, your physical body begins to be healed. Hallelujah. How flow can you go, people? Out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. I love you all. I love you. Thank you for listening. And once again, if you want to sow, I put it on there. I got rebuked for it, but hallelujah, I'm not going to get rebuked anymore. And I receive rebukings, people of God. I'm going to tell you right now, if somebody got something for me, I know I don't know it all. I know that I don't know it all. I'm a student of God's word, and I'm still learning. I don't know it all, and I profess that right now. I know I don't know it all. So if you got a rebuking for me or some advice you want to give me, hit a brother with it. I know how to receive. I'm not above reception, okay? So when I got rebuked for not asking, Apostle, you need to let the people sow into you, I fought it for a minute, and I said, okay, I give. I surrender. So if you want to sow, I put the cash tag for the Cash App on there, PayPal, ApostleJW@gmail.com. Look at the title of the video. It's on there. You can sow through the church. It's on there, all right? So if you guys want to sow into this and seal this word, I urge you to do so. I love you all. Thank you all for listening, and I'll see you on the next broadcast, all right? Shalom, Mishpachah. I love my family. Peace to my family. Ha shalom, ya ruach hakodesh atah. May the peace of God's Holy Spirit be with you. Hallelujah. Bless you.